Beautiful day to be alive, Babaji. Beautiful day. Beautiful day to be alive.
Good morning and happy Sunday.
This Sunday we are online.
Okay. Good morning, church.
Good
And
morning.
welcome to service today. As we welcome ourselves to God's presence, God will call us to worship this morning as we read from the scriptures. Today, we shall be reading from the book of Philippians, chapter number 2, verse 5 to 11. The epistle of Paul to the church in Philippi, chapter 2, verse 5 to 11. Let's bow down our head and hearts as we listen to the word of God. Have this mind among yourselves, which is yours in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. We have come this morning to that name that is above every name. The Bible wrote that the name of the Lord is a strong tower, and the righteous run into it and are safe. For those that are burdened and heavy laden, come to this name and find rest. For the yoke is easy and the burden is light. May the Lord meet with us individually and as a church as we come to his presence this morning. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Let us sing together this morning. We'll take some time of singing and then we will pray. I will lift up your name, I am. I will lift up his name, I am. Oh, Jehovah,
Alpha, Omega.
I will lift up your name, oh Jehovah, Alpha and Omega. I will lift up your name, I will lift up your name, I will lift up your name, oh Jehovah, Alpha and Omega. I will lift up your name, I am. Oh, Jehovah, Alpha and Omega. I will lift up your name, I am. Jehovah reigns.
You are lifted up above all that God.
You are lifted up above other gods. You are lifted up above other gods.
Above other gods.
You are lifted up above other gods. You are lifted up above other gods. Kabi Esira Oluwa. Oba to bi mo le to so pura. Kabi Esira Oluwa. Oba to fi mo le sa shobura kilo fi mo le se wo fi mo le
mo le sa shobura
aye o fi mo le sa shobura kilo fi mo le se
o fi mo le sa shobura
ato ba jaye
o le sa shobura
Oba
Tabanta
Oba Rekpete Rekpete
Oba Tabanta
Oh Jesus mi Oba Rekpete Rekpete Opeye Oluwa
Oba Tabanta
Oh Jesus mi
Oba Tabanta
Oba Re
You
are lifted up
above all the gods.
You are lifted up
above all our God.
You are lifted up
above all the God.
You are lifted up
above all the God.
Come, let us adore you. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Christ. For he alone is worthy. I want you to lift up your voice and worship him this morning. He alone is worthy of our praise. He alone is worthy of our exaltation. He alone is worthy of all the glory in all the world. I want you to worship his majesty. I want you to bless him. I want you to appreciate him. He's the King of God. I am. Call him the name that he is. He is our King. Maker. I want you to thank him for who he is.
You, Lord, we lift up your name, Lord. Father, Lord, we thank you, Jesus, for who you are and for what you could be and do in our life. Let your name be praised, O Lord. Let your name be exalted, O Lord. Let your name be magnified, O Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you for your love. Thank you for healing. Thank you for deliverance. Thank you for restoration. Thank you for lifting us up high. May your name be praised, O Lord our God. May your name be lifted up, high, our God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We magnify you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We magnify you. We worship you, Lord. We magnify you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord our God. May your name be praised, O Lord. May your name be praised, Lord. May your name be exalted, O Lord. May your name be exalted, O Lord. May your name be magnified, O Lord. May your name be lifted up, O Lord. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, my God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, may your name be praised, O Lord. May your name be exalted, O Lord. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. And labor post grace. Thank you, Father, for your power. Thank you, Father, for your will. All glory to you, Lord, my God. Thank
in
you,
Jesus. Jesus' name, we are praying.
Amen.
I want you to say, Jesus, I have come to worship you today. Touch my life. Let me not go back home the same way.
Let me not go back home the same way.
Oh, Lord, let me experience your touch. Touch me today, Holy Spirit. Come, touch my life again. Speak your word to my heart again today. In the name of Jesus.
Oh, Lord, touch my life.
Speak your word
to my heart. Touch my life, oh, Lord. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, touch my life, O Lord. Transform my life, O Lord. Do something new and great in my life, O Lord. Meet me at the point of my need today, O Lord, my God.
In Jesus' name, we are praying.
Thank you, Jesus.
In Jesus' name, we are praying. Our Father, grateful for another time in your presence. We want to bless you. We want to honor you. We want to adore you. You are our King. There's nobody that can be compared to you, and we appreciate you for who you are in our life. Blessed be your name in the name of Jesus. Today, we pray that you accept our worship service. You will bless us, and we will be blessed by you, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. None of us will come back home, go back home the same way. You will speak your word to us. You will give us blessings, much more than we can ever think or imagine, in the name of Jesus. Thank you. In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen. We are all welcome again to church today. It's a beautiful last Sunday of the month. We will be spending time to appreciate God today and be spending time to bless His holy name for granting us another beautiful, beautiful month. The month of September has been a great, great month. At this hour, we will listen to a song ministration, after which we will read the scriptures, then we will take offering, then we will hear the word of God. See the order again. We will take a song ministration now. We will read the scriptures, and we will take the offering. Then we will read the word. We will minister the word of God in prayers. I am praying that today again, every moment that we'll be having in God's presence, it will experience an either encounter with Jehovah in Jesus Christ's name. Thank you. You are welcome again. Happy Sunday to everyone. Can we have the song ministration now? God bless you.
Good morning, church. Today I will be singing the blessing by Revelation Worship. I hope you all enjoy it in Jesus' name.
I'm not sure we are hearing you.
I've not sung yet. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. 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 Keep you, make his face shine upon you, and be gracious to you. Lord, turn his face toward you, and give peace.
We bless God for that. We have the closing, the scripture reading.
And a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children, and his favor is upon you. And a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children, may his favor be upon you. And a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, their children, and their children, may his favor be upon you. A thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children, may his presence go before you, and behind you, and beside you, all around you, and within you. He's with you, he's with you, in the morning, in the evening, in the coming, and the going, and the weeping, and rejoicing. He's for you, 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 he's for you. Ah.
If your Bibles are with you, can we open our Bibles to the book of Acts of Apostles, chapter 13? We'll just be reading one Bible verse. We will all read it together. Acts of Apostles, chapter 13, verse 36. We will all read it together. So unmute yourself while we read. Together. Acts of Apostles, chapter 13, verse 6. We will read in Jesus' name. For when David had served God's purpose in his own generation, he fell asleep. He was buried with his father and his body decayed. For when David had served God's purpose in his own generation, he fell asleep. He was buried with his father, and his body decayed. May God bless the hearing and the reading of this text in Jesus' name. Amen. At this hour, we would like to thank God for the opportunity to give our offering. Usually, when we are on site church, we say offering time, and the church will respond blessing time. Offering time now, everybody. Offering time, blessing time. One more time, offering time.
Blessing time.
We are in a crucial time in the history of the church and the history of our world today, where a lot of things are done electronically. What that means is that we don't have to physically be together before we are able to, we don't have to be physically together before we are able to do the things that we want to do. They seems to point us to one scripture in the Bible that says a time will come when true worshipers will have the capacity to worship in spirit and in truth. That is not until I get to Jerusalem that I will be able to worship the Lord, whether by worship, by singing, by reading scripture, by preaching, or by offering. The time has come, and the time is here now. It does means that we can give our offering, and we can give our tithes, and we can give our special offerings, even though we are physically apart. What is the platform? What does the platform enable us to do today? In order to give this offering, offering bags that we pass will be passed in three ways. Number one, for those of us that are in Canada, to give your offering, you can give your offering through the Interact service. The Interact is the email service where you'll be able to give your offering. You know, those of you in Canada know how this is done. It is done by going into your app and going to send money, and the Interact email is oasis@radiallife.net is posted on the chat venue. oasis@radiallife.net. oasis@radiallife.net. That is the Interact email. With that email, you can give your offering, whatever amount, and there will be a portion there that states the purpose of the offering. Whether it's an offering, whether it's a tithe, whether it's a donation, you just state it there. and it will capture it. For those of us outside of Canada, you can also give your offering through a PayPal. The same PayPal address is oasis@radiantlight.net too. If you search oasis@radiantlight.net, you will be able to pay through the PayPal. And now for everyone else that does not have access to Oasis, to a PayPal, you just go to our website. The email of the website, the address of the website is radiantlight.net. If you Google radiantlight.net, you will see our email. You will see the website. And as soon as you open the website, you will find a donate button. Depending on the device you are using, either on the left or the right or down. Or you click into the menu and you will see the donate button will scroll down. You click on the donate button and it will bring a form out where you will be able to give. And as you do, God will guide you and bless you in Jesus' name. We will pray now, hoping that as soon as we finish praying, you will give your offering. And we'll take just one song and we'll go into the time of praying of the word of God. Our Father, as we give our offering at this hour, whatever the platform that we are using, your word says it is more blessed to give than to receive. As your people give, we ask you will give to them. As your people give, we ask that you will bless them. As your people give, we ask that this week, the devourer is rebuked on their behalf in the name of Jesus. We pray that Father, as they give today, you will bless them much more abundantly, much more than they are ever thinking or ever going to ever imagine. You will open the floodgates of heaven unto them and they will be abundantly blessed in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, Lord, we bless your name. We magnify you. That because today again, you will confirm your word. Heaven will be opened upon our lives. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. We will take just this song while we are giving that song. As we take the song, God bless you in Jesus' name. Thou art worthy. Thou art worthy, O Lord. Oh Lord, to receive glory, honor, and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are our created. That worthy, thou art worthy, O Lord. Oh Lord, to receive glory, honor, and power, for thou hast created all things, and for thy pleasure they are our creed. Magnify the Lord with me, exalt the name of Jesus. Magnify the Lord with me.
Yeah.
Exalt the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Magnify the Lord with me. Exalt the name of Jesus. Magnify the Lord with me. Exalt the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Magnify the Lord with me. Exalt the name of Jesus. Magnify the Lord with me. Exalt the name of Jesus. You are high and lifted up. There is no one like you. Hallelujah. You are high and lifted up. There is no one like you. Alle, 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 Hallelujah. Our Father, we thank you, Father. We pray that our worship, our offering be acceptable to you, Lord our God, in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you for answering our prayers. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Right, this hour I want you to begin to magnify the name of the Lord for your life and for how God has led you this month. How God has led you this month. This is the last Sunday in the month of September. A lot of things have happened this month. Go ahead and just say thank you to Jesus. Go ahead and say thank you to Jesus. Go ahead and say thank you to Jesus. He's been God. He's been God. He's been God. The Lord himself has been the one that has kept you. Say, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for each day of this month. Thank you, Father, for preservation. Thank you for restoration. Thank you for revival. Oh, Lord, I return the glory back to you. May your name be praised, Lord, my God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Begin to thank God for healing. 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 Say thank you, Father, for healing. Thank you, Father, for healing. We give you the glory. We give you the glory. All glory to you, Lord our God, in Jesus' name. All glory to you, Lord our God, in the name of Jesus. I want you to pray at this hour again. Begin to pray and say, Lord, thank you for forgiveness of sin. Thank you for forgiveness of sin. Thank you, Father, for cleansing me and purifying me. Thank you for justifying me. Lord, I give you the praise, Lord, in the name of Jesus. I want to thank God for the goodness of the Lord that you have experienced in this month. Say, Lord, my God, I thank you. I thank you for the goodness I've experienced this month. Let your name be praised, Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. I want you to begin to commit into the hands of the Lord. The rest of the month for you, we just have a few days to go this month. Say, Lord, you will keep me. Lord, you will keep my family. Lord, you will strengthen me. Lord, you will make, you open the doors of greatness to me, oh Lord. This month, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Lord, my God, the blessings that you have for me, oh Lord, will not pass me by this month, Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. The blessings you have for me, oh Lord, will not pass me by this month, Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. Reposun tolia matinia makuskelia. Rekepolia bakutkelia bakutolia bakuskelia bakutkelia. Misetelia batubo rikestum tolia bababa. Rupo sotolia batuboria basutolia. In the lip of Kolia Bashiti. I want you to begin to say, Lord, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you again, oh Lord. I want you to commit the rest of the month into the other and say, Lord, take absolute control. Give me breakthrough, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus. Give me breakthrough, oh Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. I want you to pray for one of your friends. Or two at the most that have asked of you for prayers, or that did not ask of you, but that you know needs your prayer. Mention their name to the Lord. Now, prayers in Jesus' name. Let's pray for our friends. Let's pray for our friends. Say, Lord, I ask that Father, you will just minister. You will minister. Oh Lord, my God. Oh Lord, to this my friend, Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. You will minister to this, my friend, oh Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus. You will minister yourself, oh Lord, to this, my friend, oh Lord, my God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. You will minister yourself, oh Lord. Lord, I lift up, oh Lord, that lady that we met again yesterday. Your power himself, your power, oh Lord, will transform her and gather her desires, oh Lord, my God, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, my God, I pray for even all of my brethren, oh Lord, and radiant life, oh Lord, you will minister to them yourself. You will give them victory and breakthrough, Lord, in the name of Jesus. There will not be any loss of life for the rest of the year, oh Lord, in and around their lives, oh Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. You will keep them, oh Lord, you will strengthen them. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ's name, we pray. Amen. Send a word to me, oh Lord. Pray. And God, send me a word today, Lord. Let me hear your word. Let your word minister to me. Father, Lord, in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, send me your word, O Lord. Let me hear your word and let your word minister to me in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Send me your word today, O Lord. Let your word minister to me, light, O Lord, and spirit. In Jesus Christ, they will pray. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ, they will pray. Amen. The scripture says, the entrance of your word giveth light and giveth understanding to the simple. Let your word enter into us. Give us understanding today. Let this word be simple. Let it be clear. Let it transform our life. Let us set, let it set us free. Let it bring salvation. Let it bring deliverance in the name of Jesus. Let it bring wholeness in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. You are welcome again at this hour. I want us to consider quickly what we call follow the why. Follow your why. Follow your why. Follow your why. What are you following? What are you following? Let me quickly tell you something to people of God as we look into that scripture. This life is full of questions. This life is about questions, actually. Life is about questions. You will ask a lot of questions yourself in this world that we are in. In while you are in school, you'll be asked a lot of questions. At home, you will ask a lot of questions. Life is a continuous weaving of a lot of questions and answers. It is as answers are provided to questions that we say we have access to solutions. It is as answers are provided to questions that we say we have access to solutions. So a lot of people are called solution providers. We are supposed to be problem solvers. Problems are questions. They are nothing more but questions. Every time you encounter a problem, every time you encounter a challenge, you are experiencing and encountering a question that requires answers. You are also aware of the journalistic questions, the what, the who, the where, the when, the why question. What is it all about? What is it all about? Where am I going? Where am I going? When am I getting to where I'm going? Where am I going to where I'm going? When am I getting to where I'm going? How do I get there? How do I get there? Then why am I doing what I'm doing? A lot of questions like that. But among all of these questions, there's one question that we want you to begin to follow much more than the others. Well, it's not as if others are not important, but this question, the question of why, it brings about every other thing and gives meaning to your life. When you ask the question why, you are asking the question of purpose. When you and I ask the question why, it changes the calculations completely. It changes the approach completely. When you ask why, it gives meaning to what. When you ask why, it gives perspective to when. When you ask why, it helps you to affirm whether the where you are going to is really where you are supposed to go to. When you ask why, it defines and re-strategizes on the how. Why is powerful. Why is powerful. The why question is a question of purpose. Now, in the text we read, a crucial text I like you to underline in your Bible. A text I like you to underline and see in your Bible. It talks about David. Say, for David, after he has served his own generation, by the will of God, fell on asleep and was laid unto his fathers and saw corruption. Now, I tell you, people of God, as much as we do not like to talk about death, we don't like to hear about death. We don't like to examine the issue of death. But death is a fact of life. Death is a fact of life. The Bible talks about death here for believers. It calls it falling asleep. Why? When a believer dies, his life does not end there. A believer's life does not end at death. So we do not end up grieving like people that do not have a hope. There is a life after death. There is a life after death for me beyond the now. That is why the matter of a believer dying is not a believer dying as said by this scripture. It's about sleeping. Believers trust it and they sleep in the Lord. They sleep in the Lord. And there are two things, destinations that are common to all men, all people. It is either people die or there is a rapture of the saints. For believers, it is either by death or by the rapture of the saints. We do trust God and hope that soon the rapture of the saints will take place. Now, two things I said. Number one, death or falling asleep is before all men. But beyond that, there is another experience called the rapture of the saints. Are you prepared for the rapture of the saints? What is the rapture of the saints? The Bible talks about it in several places in the book of Matthew and in Thessalonians. Talk about a time when the dead in Christ will rise first. And those of us that are alive will be raptured from this world. And we will take it to the sky to meet the Lord Jesus. That is the next event on the agenda. That is the next event in prophecy. The rapture of the saints will take place anytime. And that's why we are considering the reason for us to follow our why. Because the rapture can take place anytime. As we so speak now, the rapture can take place. It can take place at night. The Bible talks about it in the book of Matthew. That two will be going and one will be taken. There will be an airplane flying and the pilot is a believer is taken. The air hostess is a believer, she's taken. All the children are dead, they are believers, they are taken. Rapture of the saints is an event that will happen anytime soon. How prepared are you? To be prepared for the rapture of the saints, the most important step today is to accept Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. Is to give your life to Jesus. Is to ensure that Jesus lives in you and you live in him. Is to follow him. Is to make Jesus the Lord and Savior of your life. Is to ensure that you remain a believer. Is to ensure that you do not apostate. You do not backslide. You do not turn away from him. Jesus Christ is about to come. He's coming. He will appear in the sky with thousands and thousands of angels and with the trumpet of the archangel. There will be a mighty blowing. An announcement will be made. And those in death in Christ will be taken first. And those of us who are alive, we will just move. Then end all viruses. Then end, whether it's coronavirus, whether it's first wave, second wave, 15th wave, it does not matter the wave anymore. You are gone. The Bible says we will be changed. Our body will be changed. We will discard mortality for immortality. The rapture of the saints is an event a believer should look forward to. It will happen soon. It will happen soon. So whether it be dead or rapture of the saints, we should know that that is one event that is all ahead of everyone. But we are just praying that we will not suffer death and we will not suffer corruption. That we will live long and we will be blessed with longevity. But if rapture will take place, that we will not be left behind. That you and I will not be left behind. To not be left behind is to follow after the master. It is safe obedience to him. To be obedient to him. To follow him. To ensure that we will walk in step with Jesus. We walk in step with the Holy Spirit. We have to quickly remind you, people of God, that again, this week, as you go, please keep in step with the Spirit of God. Because as good as your investments are on earth, as good as everything you are trying to do here now, the projects you have before you, the getting of a job that you have before you, the houses you want to buy, the completing the degree program you want to do, the planning of marriage as beautiful as they are, there is this event that will usher us into the millennium, that will usher us into God's presence, where all solutions are provided for. The event will happen soon. Don't miss the rapture of the saints. That's what the scripture was referring to in that verse 36, where it talks about falling asleep. But then he talked about the man there, the man David. The Bible said David fell asleep. He was not privileged to be raptured, but you can be certain when the rapture takes place, he is going to be part of the people that will first of all rise from the dead, and they will meet the Lord Jesus in the sky. But then this baby, before he died, before he fell asleep, the Bible says he served God's purpose on that. He served his own generation. That's the second thing I'm talking about. That this life is designed by generations. This life that we are in is designed by generations. The generation of David is gone. There was a generation of Moses. There was a generation of your grandfather. There was a generation of your dad. Now this is your own generation. If this is your generation, as you answer the question, what am I doing? As you answer the question, where am I going? As you answer the question, when am I going to get it done? As you answer the question, how am I supposed to approach it? Also find a way to answer this question and follow it. Which question? Why am I doing what I am doing? The question of purpose. Why? Why? Where purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. Where purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. What is your purpose of living? You need to know. What is your purpose of living? Why am I here on earth? If you don't know your purpose on earth, you will be abused, and you yourself will become an abused person. You become even an abuser. You need to find out from God and look inwards into yourself and ask that question, why? It's not just only your purpose for existence. It's also your purpose for doing whatever you are doing. Your purpose for doing whatever you are doing. If you just will answer that question, why? It will change, and you will sincerely answer that question. It will change everything. It will change the what. It will change the how. It will change the when. It will change the where. Answer that question, why? Why am I doing what I'm doing? Why am I eating what I am eating? Why am I pursuing the project I'm pursuing? Why am I relating with this person I am relating with the way I'm relating it with the person? Why? Why? This week, I challenge you. Ask the question, why? Tag why on everything you are watching, you are doing. If you are watching a movie, ask yourself, why am I watching this movie? If you are going on a trip, ask yourself, why am I going on this trip? If you are relating with someone, ask yourself, why am I relating with this person? The project you are pursuing, as you are pursuing the project, can you please just ask yourself, why am I pursuing this project? Why am I in this relationship? Why am I in this association? Why am I doing what I am doing? The why question. But as you question everything you do, and question when you are doing it, and question where you are going, how you are going about doing it, most importantly, these are the answers you provide for this why. Does it answer the question of your ultimate existence? Of why you are in this particular generation? Why? What is your purpose in life? Let your life be purpose driven. Let your life be purpose driven. Let your life be purpose, madam. Let your life be purpose driven. Sir, let your life be purpose driven. Today, let's learn from this man of God, David. The Bible says, when David has served his own generation, God's purpose in his generation, he fell asleep. Before you fall asleep, before the rapture of the saints takes place, are you serving God's purpose in this generation? Examine this again. I want you to take time for self-reflection. Take time for self-reflection, people of God. God wants us today to examine why we do what we do. God's will and purposes and counsel for your life matters a lot. Do you think God will back a project that he has no hand in? Ask yourself over again. Why? Why? Let that why question reverberate in your life this week. Why? Why? When you ask why, and you sincerely answer it, I tell you the truth, there are a lot of things that you will stop. You will just stop doing them. Because the answer to the why is outside of God's will. Because the answer to the why is not sufficient for the sacrifices you are making. Because for the answer to the why that you have asked, it will change your questions, all the equations. And you know that even though you are supposed to do what you are doing, the timing is not ripe. The timing is not now. Ask that question. Why? Why do I want to get this thing done? Now let me tell you also that you will not get confused. What are we saying today? What is God telling us today? God is helping us to examine Acts of Apostles, chapter 13, verse 36. Which read again, I read. It says, for when David had served God's purpose in his own generation, he fell asleep. He was buried with his father, and his body decayed. And I start by telling us, there are some things that are coming to all men. All men will fall asleep one day. There is no doubt about it. Whether you think about it, whether you accept it or not, it will happen. But we are now saying, as much as we desire, and we really pray it, and I'm praying for somebody here, that God will bless every one of us here today with longevity of life. God will bless you, and you will grow old. You will grow old with your spouse in the name of Jesus. You will grow old and become a blessing in this world in the name of Jesus. You will not die young. Your eyes will not grow dim. I will look for that instead of dying. God says we should look at it. There is another event that is likely to take place in our time. It's called the rapture of the saints. But before the rapture takes place, the rapture is certain it will happen. Even though we are behaving as if it will not happen, even though the world is not talking about it, even though your church and my church have stopped talking about it, we have stopped talking about the rapture of the saints, even though all signs on the world tell us that it is the next event that's about to happen. It is the next event that is about to happen. Even though all of that happens, what should you and I focus on doing while waiting for the rapture to happen as the next agenda? We are told us that we should learn from this man called David. He served God's purpose in his generation. You and I should serve God's purpose in our generation. In order to serve God's purpose in our generation, ask yourself a simple question. Why? And I told us, I said that the why question is just one question among the other questions. Is it what? What am I doing with my life? Is it how? How am I going about living? Is it when? When am I going to do what I'm supposed to do? Is it where am I really going to in the things I do? We said, the questions that you tie all of them together is just, why am I really in this world? Why am I existing? Ask this question. When you answer this question, it changes everything. It changes friendship. It changes projects. It changes timing. It changes friendship. It changes project. It changes timing. Why? When you get the answer to why, follow your why. Follow your why. When you follow your why, you follow purpose. When purpose is known, abuse will give way. When purpose is known, there will be clarification. When purpose is known, there will be tenacity. When purpose is known, there will be speed. When purpose is known, there will be fulfillment. This week, may you be fulfilled as you discover purpose for living. Let us pray. I want you to, at this hour, begin to magnify the name of the Lord and say, Father, help me to discover my why. Help me to discover my why. And if you have discovered your why, help me, oh Lord, to follow my why. Give me courage to follow my why. Give me courage to follow purpose. Give me courage to question the things I do and not just exist, but to follow my essence, to follow your will for my life, oh Lord, in this generation. Go ahead and begin to say, God, give me purpose. Give me clarity of purpose. Yeah, that's prayer. Give me clarity of purpose. Lord, my God, in the name of Jesus. Give me clarity of purpose, Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. Let my life not just be on autopilot. Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. We have 5 prayer points. I want you to quickly pray them 1 minute after the other. God, give me clarity. Give me clarity. Give me clarity. Because when you have answer why, it slows you down in the things you are doing and gives you meaning. Give me meaning to living. Give me meaning to living, Lord. In the name of Jesus, give me living. And don't let me just join the rat race of life. Or just waking up and going up and down and coming back and just sleeping. Then you wake up again. Then you go up and down. No direction. Father, Lord, my God, give me purpose, oh Lord. Help me to clarify my purpose. Help me to follow my purpose in the name of Jesus. Help me to question what I am doing. Help me to question when I am doing what I'm doing. Help me to question where I am going. Help me to question the how I am going about what I am doing. Help me to question it with a why, oh Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, everlasting Father. I want us to pray for the second prayer point on the matter of rapture. I want you to pray, Lord, whatever is in my life, oh Lord, that it is disqualifying me to be a candidate of rapture, remove it from my life today. Every habit in my life that is tending to make me like Lot's wife, Lord, my God, break through that habit. Help me, oh Lord, and give me an inner change today. Let me question that habit and let me forsake the habit. Are you praying? Let me question that habit and let me forsake the habit in the name of Jesus. Let me question habit. Is there something in my life that I am currently holding on to, but that has capacity to make me look back? Father, at the moment that is important, oh Lord, today, Lord, give me grace to question it and to review it in the name of Jesus. Give me grace to question it and to review it in the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. Number 3, I want to pray and say, Lord, for me, no death in my life. I rebuke no death in my estate, no death in my family. I rebuke the power of death in Jesus. Death, you have lost your grip over my soul. Death, you have lost your grip over my family in Jesus' name. I want to secure your family. I say, Lord, I soak every member of my family in the blood of Jesus. Are you praying? I soak every member of my family in the blood of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we will not take the wrong step. We will not go the wrong direction. We will not be foolish to kill ourselves. We will not be foolish to misbehave and kill ourselves. In the name of Jesus, I secure my children with the blood of Jesus. There will not be accidents, oh Lord. No accidents of any kind. Are you praying? No accident of any kind. In the name of Jesus Christ. No accident of any kind. In the name of Jesus. Some people are contemplating suicide. I want to pray for them. I say, Lord, all the people within my estate, I mean within your family, that are so depressed, contemplating taking their life, Lord, I stop it now in Jesus' name. Are you praying? I stop it now in Jesus' name. I stop it now in Jesus' name. Oh Lord, give my friends, my family, my members, give them peace of mind. Give them peace of mind with the why question. Oh Lord, my God, so that they will not go ahead and take their life in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, everlasting Father. You know, there are people that are ready and about to die. For one reason or the other, under sickness. Just like Joseph Christ. God, save me. And God saved him. Just like Ezekiah cried, God, save me. And he was saved. I want to pray and say, Lord, I cry. Father, I stand in the gap for my friends. I stand in the gap for my brethren. Lord, save them, Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. Save them, oh Lord, from death. Save them, oh Lord, from accidents. In the name of Jesus. Are there people hurting themselves? Taking in chemicals. Hey, I want us to pray for those that are addicted, that are under one addiction, and that addiction is killing them slowly. I want to pray. I say, Father, deliver this friend of mine from addiction. Deliver, set them free now in Jesus' name. Are you praying? Set them free now in Jesus' name from this addiction that is leading them to death. Lord, set them free now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. The Bible says that sin shall not have power over you. Oh, because the wages of sin is death. Lord, I pray, Father, you will cause death to lose their grip, sin to lose their grip over these people. Oh, Lord, my God, in Jesus' name. Thank you, everlasting Father. We give you the glory. We magnify you. Well, I want you to pray finally. Help me to fulfill purpose, oh Lord, in this my generation. Prayers in Jesus' name. Help me, Lord, to fulfill purpose in my generation. Help me to fulfill purpose, oh Lord, as I follow my wife. In the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Just before I pray, I want you to listen to this. When you follow your wife, sometimes it can be very lonely because you are not following the crowd. When you follow your wife, sometimes you have to just keep focus. You have to focus. And people might not understand what you are doing because you are following your wife. You are following your essence of living. You are following the purpose for which God has created you. Remember Joseph. God revealed to him who he was, who he is supposed to be. And people misunderstood him. Even people closest to him misunderstood him. But he kept focused on his why. And eventually he became his purpose. I am praying for you today. You will fulfill purpose. You will fulfill purpose. In the name of Jesus. You will fulfill purpose. In the name of Jesus. Every barrier to your fulfilling purpose, today I remove them from your pathway. In the name of Jesus. Today I command resources from the north, resources from the south, resources from the east, resources from the west, resources from the central to come your way and enable you to fulfill purpose. All that you will need to fulfill purpose, may it be available to you in Jesus' name. I decree that you will access grace to fulfill purpose. In the name of Jesus. Let there be peace in your heart. Let there be joy in your heart. In the name of Jesus. This week, as you review by asking that question, your life, I pray, there will be a new beginning for you. And this new beginning will be a beginning of serving God's will in your generation. And you will be a blessing indeed. In the name of Jesus. And you will not be a liability. In the name of Jesus. For all of you that have been considered a liability, I pray for you. We are people who have considered you a liability. As you go and pass through there, you will be considered a blessing. No more a liability. In the name of Jesus, it is well with you. In Amen. Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Thank you, Pastor, for that word. We will sing when the role is called up yonder. Let's sing together. When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saving path shall gather over on the other shore, and the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is called up yonder,
When the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. On the bright and cloudy morning, where the dead in Christ shall rise.
And the glory of his resurrection share. When his chosen ones shall gather to their home beyond the skies, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Let us lay before the master from the dawn Let us talk of all this wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the road is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder,
I'll be there.
When the road is called up yonder,
when the road
is called
up yonder,
when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder,
we'll be there
when the road is called up yonder. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Before we share the grace together, a few announcements we want to share with us quickly. We ask, trusting God, that this week will be a great week for each one of us. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we do appreciate all of us that were able to join today. Let's make it a time again, same time next week, no matter the part of the world that you are in. Let's make it another opportunity, same time next week. God will bless you and I in Jesus' name. This evening, for those of us in North America, we'll be having a Sunday school by 7 p.m. Manitoba time, by 6 p.m. Alberta time, by 8 p.m. Ontario time. Ontario time is same with Maryland and New York time. So the school is really important. We have three groups, adult groups. Our fathers and mothers, we are together to discuss intensively. And we have the kids class. It's a beautiful time to learn from God. And we have the teens class. Please tell someone to be part of us today. At that time, I have announced. It's through the same Zoom address. And you'll be blessed as we look at it. We are looking at intentional loyalty today. Intentional loyalty. God bless you as you join us in Sunday school this evening. Let us unmute ourselves so that we can share the grace together in fellowship. Let's unmute ourselves so that we can share the grace together in fellowship. Unmute yourself so that we can share the grace together in fellowship. Let's unmute ourselves. Okay, let's share the grace.
In grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Of the Holy Spirit,
be with us now and forevermore.
Amen. And surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us
all the days of our life.
And we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen.